privilege to have in our company now, better known in the Calypso area, arena, Brian London. You're part of the football coaching course, the C-license course. Tell us what really made you want to get into involved in something like this.
Okay, right now I'm doing my degree in sports studies at the University of Trinidad and Tobago, and they sent me along to other students here to try and give more knowledge so that we can help the university. But they have the intercampus games where you have schools like UTT, University of the West Indies, SAMS, Project, and I mean, we go a long way in helping the school to go forward in terms of coaching and that kind of thing. I have the basic knowledge. Impact on the students to take part in the competitions, they're looking for outside help.
Are you a fan of football?
Yeah. I'm a fan of football, I'm a fan of good football again. Really have no specific team, but I like to see good football. Yeah.
What made you want to get involved into the sports education at UTT? Why sports?
I think that when you look at it from a community aspect, we find a lot of the communities around the Trinidad and Tobago, they are lacking individuals. I mean, they are those who have the passion but not the knowledge. You know, and I think you need to have both in order to impart proper knowledge and skills and technical abilities of their charges. So then it's about just trying to build my community and by extension, Trinidad and Tobago.
Based on what you've experienced over the past few days here in Rosilac, do you see yourself a little more knowledgeable about the game now?
Yeah, I told somebody this, but I gave myself 2 years to start working with the national team. I'm not sure what age, and by the next 4 years, be working with the national senior team in some capacity. There's no goal.
Is that an ambition of yours?
Yeah, I want to achieve what I've set out to achieve. So I think that is, but I mean, it has made me look at things in a different light. You know, as I say, sometimes as a coach, you want to impose your will and your way upon players, and they're not able to go through the process of problem solving on their own. And I think the Dutch way is about having players go through the fine points for themselves. I'm trying to figure out, you know, I've already done this instead of this instead of you just. So as a coach now, you are like the guy that decides.
No, Calypso and football, does it go hand in hand, you feel?
Yeah, well, you know, before you go to Super Warriors, they used to call it Kaiso Soccer. You know, so it's Kaiso Soccer and Soccer, you know, that kind of way. So I've always been a fan and advocate of Trinidad and Tobago's football. I mean, as any other fan of Trinidad and Tobago, like to see us reach the World Cup again. I think we do have the players. I hope that the new coach brings some new ideas and new visions and new tactics into the team that can help develop the younger players and that we can see our core players that can take us not just to one World Cup, but to 2, 3 or even.
You've been a commentator in the political arena as well, obviously, through your music. We all know what the situation is now with regards to our vice president or suspended vice president in Jack Warner. What are your hopes for what is taking place now, especially at the level of FIFA?
But I hope that it can resolve and that he can be reinstated. You know, I think that the Caribbean and the region, CONCACAF on the whole, has benefited from Jack Warner's input in the football. I mean, any allegations of corruption in any circle, whether it be FIFA or otherwise, I mean, has to be investigated. And I hope that it is thoroughly investigated, and when he is set free, that he can get along with the business of football. And I also hope that now, although he is suspended, that we can still get along with the business of football, because football has to continue.
All right, great. Thanks a lot and good luck.
No problem.